Folks, how Crex here. All right, I'm just doing a update. I just finished up these Circle Orboros miniatures tonight. If you watched my last stream I had on my channel, you would have seen some work done on these guys. I just finished them up tonight and just wanted to do an update video. Mostly to show them off to the individual that does own these. This is goes out to a friend of mine who wanted them for his army, and well, he wanted someone to paint them up pretty nice. So here we go. We have this is the Circle Orboros starter box set. So if you've seen them, you know, on the website or in the store or anything, you know, I've done a little slightly different paint scheme on them. Done them in red and kind of a reddish brown look. You know, it is earth tones. And just show these guys off. All right, this is Tanith. And you see a little bit of rock effects on the base. You got some wood and grass and everything that's on here. Gives it kind of a wild look. The stonework on the bottom is actually green stuff, because when she sat on the base, she went over on the lip on both sides, and I didn't like that, so I green stuffed a base extra so she could stand on a rock outcropping. And then you have all the, it's like leather cape, you know, it's got a flowing cape, and it's all stitched together. So if you see that, it's all stitched and done up. So all I have to do is tomorrow morning I'm gonna hit this with some sealant, get it all sealed. So that's Tanith. And then we have the Wild Argus. There's two of them, two Wild Argus. And they have a little bit of gray fur on the back. You know, there's a winter Argus, which is all white. So I went kind of with the look in between. So it has kind of a grayish white look. So this might be like the summer colors of a winter Argus. So there you go. That's that one there. And then there's number two. I'm not sure which one goes into, came with the original box, or if this is an extra. If they have two of these, I don't know. Didn't have the box. I was just given the miniatures and stuff to go with it. So I put all those guys together. And then we have the Gorax. Was it the Gorax Rager? I think that is. Yeah, the Gorax Rager. This one here. That's everything. What I really liked about this, these things have some great muscle. So if you like working on painting muscle structure and stuff, these have some nice muscle structure on them. And nice mouth. Like, rawr. A lot of details on this little bugger. Looks good though. I like it. Yeah, you see a lot of these are, they do like a brass with green. You know, it's typically what's done up with Circle Orboros, but individual wanted kind of a red look. He's going for the World of Warcraft. You know, there's the newest Legion faction that's out there, and they have like demonic kind of look. So that's the kind of look we're going here. This is the Pure Blood Warp Wolf right here. A lot of detail on this guy. Lots of muscle structure, some claws, lots of leather. And I went with the, everybody's getting the grayish fur look, kind of like the summer pelt, shed it a lot, don't bring them in the house type thing. So that's the Warp Wolf. And it has some stones here. They're all glowy. Lots of leather, muscles, fur, claws. Looks good. So that's all of them for the Circle Orboros starter box set with Tanith. And these are all plastic, so they're easy to put together. And they go together pretty good. You just clean them up and glue them. And they're all ready to go. They come in green, so it's like, you know, that's the newest thing they're doing. All the different plastics are all in different colors. So Circle Orboros is green. But after priming it and putting all the paint on it, it looks pretty darn good. All right, this is Hellcrex, and you guys all have a good one.